guys, I wanted to do a review for you about Zoeva brushes. And in this case, we're gonna talk just about the eye brushes. And these are the brushes that I think are really good to have. So I'm not gonna include any that I don't think you should own. The first one I'm gonna talk about is just a classic shader brush. So the first brush that you would use to kind of put down color. And this is the classic shader, the 232. They have another shader, which is the 222, but it's really big. And for my Asian eyes, I just don't need something that big. And I'm not really sure if this is synthetic or real hair. I suspect that it's real hair, but it's really soft, dense, and it's really good for just packing on that color. Really good essential basic brush. The next brush I'm gonna talk about is kind of like the smaller cousin. You can see the size difference right there. And this is the smudger. This is a smudger brush. And I think the hair is pretty much the same material, so again, probably natural hair. The reason why the text is a little bit different, you can see, is that this is the older series. And I don't actually think they make this brush anymore in the newer series in the same way. I actually have the newer brush, and this one is also the smudger. And I'll put them next to you so you can see the difference. And you can see that the head is much shorter now, and they've actually changed the material to synthetic. And this is the one that you can still find online. I'll put the link for all the items and prices below in the description bar. I actually use them for different purposes. This one I use to pack a darker color on the outer V or the outside of my eye, basically a darker color. And this one is actually great for smudging out eyeliner here. It's not quite large enough to do the same thing as the other one, but it works. The next brush I'm gonna talk about is a large fluffy brush. This one is really good for putting highlighter under your brow bone, also blending out. It's a little big for my eye for blending it out, but for maybe larger or more deeply set eyes, this would be great. And this is just called the 228 crease brush. Oh, and I just really wanted to mention, all the eye brushes are pretty much the same length, so it makes them easy to travel with, and they feel great in your hand. Okay, back to the review. Next, I want to talk about two eyeliner brushes by Zoeva, and the first one is actually not an eyeliner brush. It's a really tiny, I would say multi-purpose brush. It's got a really tiny little tip that you can use for concealer or detail work around the eyes. And they actually call it a precision shader. Sorry, that's upside down. There we go, precision shader. And you can use this brush for really detail work around tear ducts or really tiny blemishes. I mainly use it for gel eyeliner, and it gives you really good control and a pretty thick line, so you don't have to go over and over like the really, really thin eyeliner brushes. So I really like this. Next is the smoky liner brush. I have this. Do you need it? No, not really. This is the smoky liner brush. Presumably, you're supposed to use this for getting a smoky eye. And if you're going to line under your eyes with dark shadow, like black eyeshadow or the upper ones, it's not really necessary. I think it's nice to have, It's a pretty good brush, if you can afford it. Next, I'm going to talk about blending brushes. And this is the 225 Eye Blender brush. And it's got like a relatively fluffy head. You can place color with this one, like a medium shade, and also blend out with it. This is quite perfect for me. I really use this as an overall blender as well, because like the other one, or unlike the other one, it's smaller. So if you have smaller eyes and you're looking for a blending brush, the smaller one, this is your guy. Finally, this is not a eye brush per se, but it's the lip contour brush. And this is the 330. It comes in this really nice, shiny, metallic protector cover. Pulls out just like that. And you can put it back in, and then you have something to work with. Sorry, this is a little bit dirty, but actually you can load this up with your favorite lipstick, put on the cap, throw it in your purse, and it's not gonna get everything dirty, and it saves a lot of room. So yeah, I quite like this. Nothing spectacular, but a good thing to have. Again, this is from the older line, and you can tell because the font is a little bit more stylistically, I don't know, exaggerated. And that's it. Thank you for watching.